Which brings me to my next point, the utter weakness and incompetence of the United Nations.
The UN, yeah, that's another thing. That's worthless.
The United Nations is not a friend of democracy. It's not a friend to freedom. It's not a friend even to the United States of America, where, as you know, it has its home. And it surely is not a friend to Israel. In his final year, yay. He may be the worst thing to ever happen to Israel, believe me. 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 And you know it. And you know it better than anybody. So with the president in his final year, discussions have been swirling about an attempt to bring a Security Council resolution on terms of an eventual agreement between Israel and Palestine. Let me be clear. An agreement imposed by the United Nations would be a total and complete disaster. The United States must oppose this resolution and use the power of our veto, which I will use as president 100%. Ask why? It's because that's not how you make a deal. Deals are made when parties come together. They come to a table and they negotiate. Each side must give up something. It's values. I mean, we have to do something where there's value in exchange for something that it requires. That's what a deal is. A deal is really something that when we impose it on Israel and Palestine, we bring together a group of people that come up with something that's not going to happen with the United Nations. It will only further, very importantly, it will only further delegitimize Israel. It will be a catastrophe and a disaster for Israel. It's not going to happen, folks. Reward Palestinian terrorism, because every day they're stabbing Israelis and even Americans. Just last week, American Taylor Allen Force, a West Point grad, phenomenal young person who served in Iraq and Afghanistan, was murdered in the street by a knife-wielding Palestinian. You don't reward behavior like that. You cannot do it. One way you treat that kind of behavior, you have to confront it. So it's not up to the United Nations to really go with a solution. It's really the parties that must negotiate a resolution themselves. They have no choice. They have to do it themselves, or it will never hold up anyway. The United States can be useful as a facilitator of negotiations, but no one should be telling Israel that it must be, and really that it must abide by some agreement made by others thousands of miles away that don't even really know what's happening to Israel, to anything in the area. It's so preposterous. We're not going to let that happen. Wow. When I'm president, believe me, I will veto any attempt by the UN to impose its will on the Jewish state. It will be vetoed 100%. That's what I do. I wrote The Art of the Deal. One of the best-selling all time, and I mean seriously, I'm saying one of, because I'll be criticized as I say the, so I'm going to be very diplomatic. One of, I'll be criticized. I think it is number one, but why take a chance? One of the all-time best-selling books about deals and deal-making. To make a great deal, you need two willing participants. We know Israel is willing to deal. Israel has been trying. That's right. Israel has been trying to sit down at the negotiating table without preconditions for years. You had Camp David in 2000, where Prime Minister Barak made an incredible offer, maybe even too generous. Arafat rejected it. In 2008, Prime Minister Olmert made an equally generous offer. The Palestinian Authority rejected it also. Then John Kerry tried to come up with a framework, and Abbas didn't even respond, not even to the Secretary of State of the United States of America. They didn't even respond. When I become president, the days of treating Israel like a second-class citizen will end on day one. Thank you. And when I say something, I mean it. I mean it. I will meet with Prime Minister Netanyahu immediately. I have known him for many years and will be able to work closely together to help bring stability and peace to Israel and to the entire region. Meanwhile, every single day, you have rampant incitement and children being taught to hate Israel and to hate the Jews. It has to stop.